is 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
All right, 25 minutes before 11 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in. I don't know how long it's been since you graduated from school, but I know it's been a long time since I graduated from school. If you are on Facebook or any of those socials, that you might have reconnected with some of those old friends that you had in college, right?
Yeah.
Right? Can you, have you ever heard of anybody that has, because Facebook's been around a while now, have you ever heard of anybody that reconnected with old friends, became friends again virtually on Facebook, and then decided to kind of go on a cruise or something like that?
I bet they have. Yeah. I haven't personally, yeah. But I bet they have.
Well, that's the premise of the book we're going to talk about. The book is called The Summer Sale. Wendy Francis is on the phone, and she's going to tell us about it. She is a former book editor, now writing books. She's a contributor to Good Housekeeping, The Washington Post, The Improper Bostonian. Is that right?
Yeah.
This book is called The Summer Sale. It is a novel, and I'm looking forward to hearing about it. Wendy Francis. Good morning, Wendy.
Good morning. Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah,
I'm excited to be here.
The premise sounds fun. You getting together with old friends, getting on a cruise, but you kind of put some twists in there, didn't you?
It is, and I did, yes. It's based on three college roommates, who actually have been getting together pretty much every year or so. They've stayed in touch since college graduation. And one of them is about to celebrate her 20th wedding anniversary, and she decides that she might as well celebrate in style, and she decides to invite her other two roommates along with her and her husband and her two boys on a cruise to Bermuda. And it's, you know, everyone's sort of dealing with their own issues and with the backdrop of the beautiful ocean and then Bermuda once they get there. The other two roommates are, one is Lee, who's a single mom with a daughter, Lacey, who's just returned from college, and she's kind of a monster, and Lee is hoping to get her sweet daughter back on this cruise. And then the third roommate's name is Caroline, and she's a successful magazine editor in New York City, but has been dating this fellow Javier for about 3 years, and she's hoping that he might finally get his act together and propose to her on the cruise.
Oh, yeah. Man.
Hers is an interesting story.
You've got a setup there. Oh, wow. And did you write it with a sense of fun? And is it based on anything at all?
I did. You know, it's funny. I have been on a cruise to Bermuda. I went on one several years ago with all of my in-laws, which at first I thought, oh boy, as much as I love my in-laws, if we're stuck on a ship for seven days and I'm seasick, this could be awful. But it ended up being a wonderful time, and you really don't get seasick on those big cruisers. And so I have been wanting to write a story about the friendships among women. You know, I find that a lot of people stay in touch with their girlhood friends or their high school girlfriends or their college girlfriends, and I wanted to get at those friendships and capture them somehow, but I was sort of struggling for the setting. And then one day it dawned to me, oh, they could all get together for a cruise to Bermuda. How much fun would that be?
That is a fun idea.
The women pride themselves in being open with each other, but still they do harbor some secrets.
Yes, yeah. Without giving too much away, Abby has a big one that she's a secret she has to tell her roommates, and she's just trying to figure out quite what the right time is on the cruise to tell them. And, you know, it's something that I hope will, in the book, brings them together, and also, again, shows the way that girlfriends can really be there for each other in times both of great fun and also some great stress.
So the way I opened up the conversation, the interview, was to say a group of people that hadn't really been in touch, but these people have been in touch the whole time.
In fact, they have, and that basis, even though the women in this book are nothing like my roommates from college, I had to be sure to make them completely different. We do try to get together once a year, and, you know, it's nothing fancy. It's just for a weekend most often, but we find that those weekends away, we plan them 6-7 months ahead of time with our husbands to make sure someone will be watching the kids, and they're just restorative. You know, it's so nice to get away and reconnect with old pals. And as you point out, I think Facebook and all the social media makes it easier to reconnect these days with folks.
But the husband isn't left out of the equation. He's very much there.
Yes, he is. He comes along. This is rare in that I should admit we've never invited our husbands along for our reunion get-togethers. But in this book, Abby's husband Sam is very much present, and he's there trying to help her come to terms with the secret she has to reveal, and also be the be in charge or help supervise their two sophomore sons who are in high school and are on the boat and enjoying everything about the cruise what it has to offer.
And so. They're twins,
yeah. And Abby's kind of dealing with the, you know, about her nest is about to empty. They're going to go off to college soon. And the cruise world, too. I don't know if either of you have ever been on a cruise, but no. It's its own little world. I had a lot of fun just observing the culture and the things that go on in the cruise. And, you know, they've got so many activities and shows. And it's, it's its own little island floating out on sea.
It's a summer-themed book. Where are you? Where are you calling from?
So I'm right outside of Boston.
Oh, okay. Yeah, and here in Florida, as you know, beaches is kind of a way of life. And a lot of people do exactly what you're talking about, not the cruise part, but about reading the book on the beach. A lot of people do this. They'll take a book to the beach, and that's how they enjoy their afternoon.
Yeah, I'm so jealous. Beaches, probably right in your backyard, yeah.
So when you're on your cruise to do all of your observations and your note-taking, what stood out for you that was similar in other the cruise people?
Uh-huh. I think first of all, you kind of get the sense that like whatever happens on the boat stays on the boat. It has that Vegas kind of feel to it. There's a casino. They have, you know, they have everything from fruit carving demonstrations to shuffleboard tournaments to there's actually a basketball court, or at least on the boat I was on, up on top. And there are places where you can hit golf balls up on top. You know, it's all sorts of stuff. You know, beyond the just lounging by the pool with a good book and a tropical drink. And the food, of course, is over the top. You know, I think my kids weighed themselves before we went on the cruise and after.
Oh, no.
they gained 7 pounds, I think, just 7 days. So, yeah.
I was looking at the other books you've written. It looks like you've got a theme going here, and I'm wondering if any movie makers, any Hollywood people, are thinking about working with you to make a movie from some of this.
Wow. Well, wouldn't that be nice? Nobody that I've talked to, but let me know if you hear anything. No, that's always the dream. But
and Elacy's an interesting character because she's at that age that she wants to be independent, but not really, but she's still at odds with her mom.
Yeah. And it was interesting, too, because I was writing her character kind of right before everything happened with the Me Too movement. And Lacey is kind of, she's fighting against her mom because her mom and her roommate friends have all been feminist and have all been about, you know, being a career woman and being able to support yourself. And Lacey's almost rebelling against that just because she's rebelling against her mom. And she's also fallen head over heels with a boy at college her freshman year. And so that's kind of warped her perspective a little bit, I guess. But, you know, that Lee doesn't give up on her. She's sure that, you know, that kernel of her sweet girl is still in there somewhere and trying to reach her.
Is it easier or harder to write characters that are not like you? I mean, we've all been younger, so maybe it's easier to write a younger character than it is somebody of the opposite sex or something like that.
That's a great question. Some characters come easier than others. All these women came very easily to me because I just felt like they could have been my girlfriends, the roommates. Lacey, actually, I hadn't meant to go into her head when I started the book, and she just kind of kept whispering in my ear, like, aren't you going to give me a voice? I have a story to tell, too. So eventually I started, she doesn't get as much space as her mom does or the other two women, but she's there, and I wanted college. I have a stepdaughter who's a sophomore in college, so she's thankfully she's nothing snarky like Lacey is. But I've hung out with enough teenage girls that I, you know, I have a little bit of a sense of how sometimes they can act.
Does the setting serve as a character? I don't know if I want to say the boat itself or the cruise as far as an activity. Does the activity of cruising become a character in a way?
Yeah, I think that's a really great point. And I think when I set out to write something, setting is so important to me. I mean, all of my novels, I think, my very first novel, Three Good Things, was set in Wisconsin, which is where I'm from originally. And that was very important. Are you kidding?
Go Badgers.
Wow. Whereabouts? Where are you from?
Cudahy. It's a suburb of Milwaukee.
Okay, awesome. Yeah, so I'm from outside Madison, and so, yeah, so it was very important to me to kind of write a Valentine to Wisconsin. So that was my first book, and then the second book is set down on the Cape, which is also a place close to my heart, and we spend a fair amount of time down there in the summers because it's a short drive from Boston. And then, yeah, and then the cruise kind of takes on a life of its own, too. So, yeah, for me, setting and characters are so important, and the plot is... The plot is the thing that I sometimes struggle with and try to figure out, well, what's going to happen and how is this going to be interesting?
Nice,
so
nice. Fun.
It's,
Wendy, thank you for being on the air with us. I found the book on Amazon, The Summer Sale. Do you want to give us a website?
Oh, sure. Thanks. So it's www.wendyfrancisauthor.com. And then I'm on Twitter and all those other places. Instagram, too, I just started, although my kids keep making fun of me because I have no idea what I'm doing. So,
Too funny.
Go ahead.
So finish your sentence. Your son?
No, I was just going to say, my son's first response was when he was trying to set me up on Instagram, said, well, first of all, your text font size is enormous. enlarged it so much. So, give you some sense of where I'm coming from. Don't expect too much on my Instagram.
Wendy, thank you. That was fun. Very fun interview. Everybody else, the book is called The Summer Sale by Wendy Francis. Thank you, Wendy.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
It was a pleasure.
We'll be right back.
Hey, Adam, those burgers gonna be done before summer's over?
Maybe. Why? You got big plans for the summer?
Not really. Just the usual, kids hanging around the house. How about you?
Actually, I'm having Joshua get his pilot's license this summer.
What? Is he old enough? Can you really do that in just the summer?
Yeah, you can get your pilot's license at 17, and the summer is plenty of time. Plus, this could be the start to his career as an airline pilot.
That is a great idea. I bet Tyler would love that. Actually, I would too.
You guys should do it.
I don't have time for that. Some of us have to work for a living, you know?
Not you, no. Seriously, they work around your schedule.
Really? That's cool. Where are you going?
Ocala Aviation, at the airport off 60th.
How'd you hear about it?
I heard about it on the radio, then I stopped in. I've got a card if you want the number.
Yeah, hold on. Let me get my phone.
Hurry up. The burgers are burning.
Okay, I'm ready. Go ahead.
861-7484.